Lorenzo Cain. And we are set for baseball here this evening. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Popped him up. And he'll indeed make the play in foul territory for the first out.
Right fielder.
In is Christian Yelich. His lifetime numbers against Bailey. Two hits in seven tries. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. Ani takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Hard hit ball to second. And quickly there are two away. So striding in, Ryan Braun, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss. Ball one. Two out, nobody on. A ball and two strikes, the count now with the bases empty and two away. Got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the... And that brings up Scott Schebler. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now here's the pitch.
Scott Schebler.
High in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted. High and deep. Way up into the moon deck and out of here. Sure, you know it's coming after that bomb. That's right. Let's check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, we see it was projected at over 450 feet. An incredible home run to watch. And here's Jose Peraza as he grounds one briskly to short. On the first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out.
First baseman.
In now for the Reds, Joey Votto. He'll get to take his first cuts here. The 0-1. Lifted the other way out to left center. Braun has a read on it. Two gone. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Eugenio Suarez, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. The bouncer to the left side, scooped up on the backhand. And the throw is wide as he couldn't keep his foot on the bag that time, and we'll have to see how they want to score that play. Here's the second baseman, Scooter Gennett. His lifetime numbers against Chacin, just a 1-for-9. Chacin comes set. Here's the first pitch. Fouled away. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Yank high and deep down the line in right. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball. Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Hit out towards second. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Coming to the plate now, Travis Shaw. And now a pitch on the way. Squared that one up just a little late. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Peraza ranging up the middle. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Stepping in, Jesus Aguilar. Here's the first pitch to him. Just a tick behind for a strike. Hit on the ground out to short. And that's the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And standing in, the left-handed hitting third baseman, Mike Moustakas. Moustakas, the former Royal, he came here by way of trade earlier this year.
I know he'd tell you he'd like to be playing a little bit better, but I think it's as advertised for this ball club right now. I think the manager is getting exactly what they expected.
Pitch on the way. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop.
Keep battling, young man. Three foul balls in a row. He is calibrating that heater and the off speed. Let's see.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three. And stepping into the box, Jesse Winker. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Winker.
Hit on the ground down the first baseline. Aguilar right there. And he'll step on first for the out. Three unassisted. At the plate, Tucker Barnhart.
Barnhart.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. After it is Kane. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Batting eighth, center fielder, Billy Hamilton.
Here's Billy Hamilton standing in. His lifetime numbers against Chassin. He's 1-for-3. Swing hard liner to left center. That gets down, and the inning continues.
Hey, they always say hitting in the eight hole in the National League is one of the toughest jobs to do. Hitting in front of the pitcher. Not necessarily going to get pitched like an eight hole hitter. You want to get out of that spot? Guess what? Newsflash. Be better. Because basically every other hitter in the lineup is hitting in front of you except the pitcher. Hey, pretty good swing right there by the pitcher. I know he'll be telling his boys in the dugout to take some hitting lessons from him if he's going to square line drives up all day.
Trying to pick things up where he left off, Scott Schebler. He'll look to duplicate his first at-bat when he homered to open the inning. First pitch of the at-bat, and he fouls this one off. Decent lead at second. Here's the pitch. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. A majestic home run. And we'll look at it again with show track. The velocity off the bat came in at 117 miles an hour. So that's one of the hardest hit home runs you'll see all year long. Amazing stuff. Shaw got it and the side is retired. But three for the Reds in the inning. All settling in now, Manny Pena. He's the number seven hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first six guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Grounder down the line at third. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Grounded back up the middle. Peraza takes it in. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Coming to the plate now, Orlando Arcia. He's ready. Here's the first offering. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. A swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball. Bases are empty, one man out. The 0-2 once more. Is a slider taken for a ball.
Pretty good discipline right there with two strikes. That's a tough sweeping slider. Not many guys lay off that pitch.
Just trying to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third. Next for Milwaukee, Yelise Chacin. And then it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three-up, three-down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Tried to stay back on the changeup there, but this is chopped foul at home plate. Here comes another 0-2. Weak chopper up the line, but that one rolls foul. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. And that one stayed too low, apparently.
Well, that's a smart miss there. Sometimes guys will chase it down there, especially when they're in protect mode on an 0-2 count.
And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Riding in once again, Joey Votto. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout.
Even though they're up by a boatload early on in this one, you can't get complacent and get lazy. They got to keep the gas pedal down because this team that they're playing can strike and score a lot of runs, too.
And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one.
Eugenio Suarez.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. Running hard. He's digging for second. And he's not stopping. He wants three. The relay throw. And they've got the runner trapped in a hot box between second and third now. And they'll just tag him here for the out. Digging in to try it again, Scooter Gennett. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Oh, here's a shot out to right center. Jeanette's going to turn for second. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. And he'll try to get back now, but it's not going to work. The throw. Now at the plate, Lorenzo Cain back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
And the flip comes to Bailey at first for the put out.
The batter.
Stepping up now, Christian Yelich. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
Hey, I'm surprised he went to that spot in his zone. This guy's known for being a down-and-in hitter. Don't expect too many pitches going in that spot.
Swing and a little tapper. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Missed with a slider.
I know he buried that slider in right there, but that's a dangerous pitch. If he doesn't pop commit and bury that inside, it leaks out over the plate. He can get hurt with that pitch.
Here now the 2-2. Locks him up for strike three.
I'll tell you, he looks really dialed in on the bump right there. He's got a shutout going, and he really seems to have this lineup off balance. Even when he challenges them up in the zone, they don't have an answer for it.
Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here, 0-1. Dribbled up the line. That goes foul. Two strikes on him now. Bases are empty here with two men out. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. So stepping in, Jesse Winker. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Winker
lifts it into the air to shallow center. Coming in on it is Kane, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. Digging in the switch hitter, Tucker Barnhart. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Towards second. Throw to first will get him. Already two away here in the home fourth. Here's Billy Hamilton standing in. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Lifted the other way to left center. On the move is Braun. And that ends the inning. And that brings up the left-handed hitting Travis Shaw. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going. And the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
Ready with the 0-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
He's just ringing up strikeouts left and right, but what's really impressive to me, he hasn't walked anyone either. He's just pounding the zone. His stuff is dirty today.
No runs, no hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Oh, and a half swing there on a pitch out of the zone. Indeed, it's strike two. Hit sharply, but foul down the right side. The next 0-2. High in the air out to center field. Hamilton is under it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Now batting, Mike Moustakas. This guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. That's yanked into the stand. Strike one. Two out, nobody on. Even one and one count to Moustakas. And he comes back with a fastball. One and two now. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And nearly into the hit column in a big way. Instead, it's a foul ball. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So here's the Reds pitcher, Homer Bailey. He reached on a single in his first try.
Homer Bailey.
Swinging a soft liner, and this will be put away easily for the out.
How about it?
And that brings up Scott Schebler. Two home runs in two at-bats so far, and looking to add to that here.
This guy's having a pretty good week so far in one game. His last at-bat is second home run of the game. We'll see if they'll pitch him a little bit more carefully in this AB.
And there's out number two. So coming to the plate, Jose Peraza. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Lifted in the air to center field. Kane is under it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Digging in for his second at-bat, Manny Pena.
We're moving through the middle of this ballgame right now. They want to get things going. How about trying to get some base runners on or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. In for strike two. The 1-2. Smoked on the ground up the middle. That's a hit, the first of the game for Milwaukee.
He had him on the ropes right there. Count leverage, two strikes against the batter. He's going to have to put that in the memory bank because that guy made a nice two-strike approach right there, made a nice two-strike adjustment.
And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one.
All right, all you're asking for as an offense is a chance. Well, your leadoff man has certainly done his part. He's gotten on base. You have to start clawing back into this game right now if you're going to find a way.
Ooh, good changeup. Just missed inside. Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Yulise Chacin. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Now a bunt attempt here. Flip to the second baseman covering now for the out. Digging in once again, Lorenzo Cain. Runner in scoring position with Sugan. way in front of a great slider that time.
I know it goes without saying, but the best pitch in baseball is getting ahead with a first pitch strike. That's why this guy's been able to stay in this game, pounding the zone.
And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game. In is Joey Votto now.
Leading off for the Reds.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Joey Votto.
Pulled toward right center field. Kane will back up and put this away for a long out number one. So here's the cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. The windup and the 0-1. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And it's gone as they add still another. So that was the third home run for these guys today.
Hero, some days the fellas walk in with their hitting shoes on, and this looks like one of those games.
Yeah, but there's a saying going around the dugout right now. There's a fight at the bat rack. Everybody wants a chance to get into that batter's box.
No balls in one strike. He's working on a one-for-two game so far. Now the pitch. Behind 0-2 now. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And another foul ball. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Looking up is Kane. That one's out of here. Back-to-back home runs. Standing in now, Jesse Winker.
Jesse Winker.
Drives it out to deep right center field. King will range to his left and put it away. Two down.
The batter, catcher, Tucker Barnhart.
Ready now for Cincinnati. Tucker Barnhart, previously against Junior Guerra. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Kane on the move. He slides and makes the catch. Ready once again, Christian Yelich. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. One away for the Brewers in their half of the seventh, and that'll bring forth the great slugging left fielder, Ryan Braun.
So far, this has been a very productive outing. We're into the middle innings of this one, and his pitch count is down, and this might be one of those starts where he can work deep into this game, possibly into the eighth or ninth inning.
Hit back up the middle, and that is through into center field for a one-out single.
Hey, after starting the game 0-for-2 with two punch-outs, that single had to feel good right there. Nice piece of hit.
Stepping in now, Travis Shaw. Strike one to start the at-bat. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Ripped on the ground to first. And he'll take this over to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner moves into scoring position at second. Stepping into the box, Jesus Aguilar. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Here's a fly ball, well hit. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Brewers strand one. Now in the box, Billy Hamilton. He flew out in his last at-bat. First pitch of the at-bat.
Billy Hamilton.
Hit down the line at first. Aguilar scoops it up, and he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. Into the box now, Homer Bailey. He's been great on the mound, so we'll see if he can do something with the bat here as well. He's earned a chance to take this at-bat.
Yeah, Matt, when a guy's throwing the ball as well as he has, it kind of forces the manager's hand to stay with him. He's been exciting to watch, and he's really had this crowd behind him the entire game.
Scott Shedley.
We'll stand in again as we flash you back to the early stages of this ball game. There were fans still finding their seats as he launched his second home run of the game, as he was off to a fast start indeed. Kane is there, and how about that? A three-pitch inning. Third baseman Mike Moustakas now. We're in the eighth now, and nothing's changed out there on the mound.
Well, I've been very impressed with how this starter's going about his business, Matt. He's looked really sharp, and it's hard to know if it's had any effect, but getting that early lead from his offense could have really helped settle him in.
On its way is pitch number 75. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Into the corner and slicing foul.
Hey, I don't mind you throwing a fastball in this situation, but I think, if we're being honest with ourselves, that one caught a little bit too much of the plate.
On to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Behind 0-2 now. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Pop foul, and it looks like that's going to make it into the VIP seats. Ready with another 0-2. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ballgame, and this one. Now at the plate, Jose Peraza. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Jose Peraza.
Left side. Played on the backhand. And a close play at first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one. In is Joey Votto now. 0-for-3 to this point.
Yeah, not his game so far. He's such a good hitter. We all kind of expect him to pick up two or three hits most of the time. That's not really how baseball works, though.
Lifted the other way out to left center. Kane is under it. And that's the second out of the inning. Making his way to the plate, Eugenio Suarez. And we'll see if he can get something into the gap to make it interesting. He's had a great game so far, but needs the triple to complete a cycle. Popped high in the air. Arcia will wait on it. And he will put it away to retire the side. Takes just four. Cincinnati's Fountain Square scene there as we welcome you back to the broadcast on MLB Network. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Two quick strikes and now the 0-2. Now a swing and he just fouls this one away. The 0-2 once more. It's a swing and a miss. That's strike three. In now is Lorenzo Cain. His dominance continues on the mound, but it seems like he might be running on adrenaline only at this point.
Yeah, he's been so great in this one. You want to see him finish what he started, but you also have to start worrying about things like injuries. He's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, and some guys are just more capable of that than others. But not a lot of good things tend to happen when you've worked as hard as he has in this one.
Shepler will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. In is Christian Yelich. He's their last shot here with two away in the ninth as they look to avoid the shutout.
Yeah, Matt, they just haven't had any.
Draw on to first is going to be in time to take care of him, and the Reds get a complete game shutout from their starter as this ball game is over. A 6-0 shutout to finish off tonight's game. The Reds jumped out to an early lead in the first. And